I'm Jalori Thomas.
And I'm Tierney Dozier.
Welcome back to the show.
Woo! Another week of school. This is totally, absolutely, positively awesome.
Why are you excited?
Because everyone knows that school is amazing and spectacular. Yeah, go school!
I'm going to throw you into the closet.
And because we love our school so much, let's move on to... Say it with me.
Fine.
Sports!
Events coming up this week.
Today there will be a varsity baseball scrimmage where BHS will face Gilbert at home. The scrimmage starts at 4 p.m.
Following that game, there will be a JV and varsity softball scrimmage against Chapin at home. The scrimmage starts at 5:30 p.m.
On Wednesday, JV and varsity lacrosse will be going up against Lexington at home. The game starts at 5:30 p.m.
On Thursday, the JV girls lacrosse teams will be going up against Akron at their home turf. The time starts at 5:30 p.m.
Following that, the JV softball will be having another scrimmage against our rival school, Westwood, on their home turf. Their time is at 6 p.m.
On Friday, the JV baseball team is ramping up to go against River Bluff at Flora MIT. It starts at 5:15 p.m.
Following that, the JV and varsity boys lacrosse team is going up against Lexington at home. The game starts at 5:30 p.m.
Later on that evening, the B team for baseball will be going up against River Bluff at home. The game starts at 7:30 p.m.
Last but not least, B team baseball will be going up against the Legion Collegiate at home on Saturday. The time is at 12:30 p.m.
Good luck to all of our Bengal athletes.
We know you'll do great.
Alrighty now. Now that we got sports covered,
it's weather time!
Okay, we're going to pretend like you didn't just do that. Despite it being winter, the weather is stated to be pretty warm, albeit with a lot of clouds.
All week, there will be cloudy skies blocking out the clouds.
Monday has a high of 69 and a low of 49.
The high on Tuesday is 72, while the high on Wednesday is 77.
The high on Thursday is 74.
However, the high on Friday is the same as Monday.
COVID/flu testing will be held once again on Wednesday and Friday in Portable F from noon to 6 p.m.
Attention to all softball players. Tomorrow you'll be taking pictures in the NPR. The time starts at 3:30 p.m.
Later that night, there will also be a drama performance open to the public. This will be held in the auditorium, taking place at 7 p.m. on Wednesday and Thursday.
There will also be a theater matinee held in the auditorium from 9 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. on Thursday. Have fun!
On Friday, the Special Olympics will be held, where our special education kids will be participating in. This will be held in both gyms from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m.
Last but not least, on Saturday, there will be a teaching fellows event held in the academic classrooms, atrium, auditorium, food court, and NPR. The time is from 7:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. We hope you attend.
Despite Black History Month being almost over, it will not be forgotten. This year, we had an unforgettable Black History Month assembly that will be one to remember. Let's take the time to recap on the assembly and how it secured its greatness.
February 10th, 2023, also known as the day of the Black History Month assembly, the most anticipated assembly of the year. After a quaint fire alarm scare, Mr. Keel started the event off with a little bit of Blythewood High School Black history, recalling the segregation of the original BHS and Bethel High School. Soon, the entertainment began to ramp up. There were a lot of performances done by the clubs and electives all around the school, including the Intense Step Team, the BHS Choir, and the West African Dance Team, all which allowed them to be rewarded with a standing ovation. However, the finale of the show was the Blackstone Union, who stood out with a genre-themed finale, which ranged from disco, pop, country, and even gospel, creating an explosive ending that will certainly never be forgotten. The reception was overwhelmingly positive, with Mr. Simpson saying he had a blast.
I liked all of it, to be honest. I really did. I love music. and there were all these different types of musical performances. You know, you had your orchestra, your steel band, your steel pans, you had your chorus, you had your Black Student Union involved, the history of music. They went through the different genres, the step team, the whole deal. I thought it was really great.
As Black History Month comes to an end, this assembly will highlight not only Black excellence, Blythewood High's will to come together and celebrate that excellence. I'm Tessa Shepherd, signing out.
That's all we have for this week, Bengals.
Thanks for watching another episode of Good Morning Blythewood.
We'll see you again next time.
Bye.
Say it with me.
Fine.
Sports. Sports. Mr. Stiles, is it Colgate or Colgate? I don't know.
Is it Colgate?
Colgate?
Oh, wait, go up.
Yeah, please.
Colgate. Okay,
Colgate. I didn't know how to say that.
Legion?
Collegiate.
What?
So no one knew how to say that.
Uh-huh. I'm not going to remember
up against the Legion Collegiate.
Collegiate.
I've never heard of that word in my life.